Hello, this is Philip and Philip from
Unleash Your Talents. You know what's one great way to unleash your talents is by showing how productive you are by getting things done in the allocated time. Because sometimes, let's face it, we get a really tough deadline and we need to figure out how to solve things. And then many people think, ooh, I need help from someone else. Do you really need to do a meeting for that? That's the question. Very often, a phone call might be enough, or an email, maybe a quick Skype, WhatsApp, whatever your means of communication is, and suddenly you realize, hey, actually, I didn't have to go to a meeting, because we all know how annoying, how exhausting meetings can be, right?
Absolutely. Of course, there are situations where you actually need to meet, to convene together, be it online or be in a physical way. In both cases, any meeting that you can cut short just to the very essential minimum amount of time helps you keep focused and helps you to actually get into getting things done. And that's the whole idea of a meeting. If you're just there and sit there and start talking and start actually talking in circles, then, well, I mean, yeah, it is technically called a meeting, but practically it's also called time waste. And I'm pretty sure everybody has, experienced this at least once.
Once or maybe hundreds of times, probably thousands of times. And there's one very easy way to shorten a meeting is, why do you always have to say it's 30 minutes or 60 minutes? How about trying a 20-minute meeting or a 50-minute meeting, a 40-minute meeting? And that's where suddenly if you add this certain amount of time pressure, your colleagues will also feel, oh, I have to be on time because it's so short, so I'd rather call in or be there on time because we only have 20 minutes. It also cuts short the chit-chat at the beginning, which is nice, don't get me wrong, but still, if you really want to get things done, then be sure that you use this time very wisely.
There is one more hack that you can actually do, very simple one in fact, keeping in mind the very basics of how to get a meeting into a proper, effective and efficient shape. Do you actually know what you're going to do during the meeting? You actually just send an agenda before the meeting. Like literally, you just send to the people, okay, guys, look here, this is what we have to do, this is what we have to talk through, and this is the goal of the meeting. Goal XYZ, whatever it is, just make sure everybody knows what's the goal of the meeting.
Exactly. If you don't know a goal, then what are you all working towards? Because you know this metaphor, everybody's pulling. Well, if you're all pulling in different directions, that will take forever and it won't get you anywhere. But I think actually, let's take a step back. Before sending out the agenda, you need to also agree on a time and a place. And it doesn't matter if this is physical or virtual. If one of these two are missing, the invitation is not complete. And I can't count the number of times where this happened that somebody said, okay, let's have a call at 12. Is this a phone call? Should I call you? Should you be sending me another Zoom link or something? Well, it's something missing. So that's why, again, if you want to show that you're a productive person, that you can get things done, be sure that the very basics of the basics of setting a meeting work every single time.
Yeah, and there is one more thing that that helps you actually work to the future. That in the future any meeting that is really relevant is done and not just any meeting. Like at the end of the meeting, when you've finished your work and when you're basically just like, okay, so what have we been talking through? What were the actual steps? Did we meet our goal? Do we have an outline for what is now up to be done? And these kind of things, they're called action items. If you share those action items to your people, well, that makes actually the whole meeting efficient because it keeps being used. It's not just like the time waster where you met and where you were randomly talking or maybe productively talking but not noting down what you actually finished. Make sure to actually send the action items and who is responsible for which action item to your people. Very simple.
Yeah. Did you notice Philip forgot one thing? Who does what until when? Don't forget this. If there's no timeline behind it, people might read it and say, yeah, so what, I'll do it anytime. And with these three together, you get action items which are actionable, which people will take care of. And again, you might have it fresh to your mind when you come out of the meeting, but a few weeks later, Maybe it's a recurring meeting once a month. You might think, oh, what did we discuss last time? Was there something I was supposed to do? And then you're happy to have this email that contains the minutes with the action items.
Exactly. If you want to have more of this kind of information, of this kind of career hacks and ideas on how to make your work life more efficient, just tune in. We are Philip and Philip from
Unleash Your Talent.
See you.
Take care.